Hello students, I am Sanjana Kavatagi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, AITM, Belgavi. Let us continue with the video lectures on storage area networks. So in this video, I'll be covering chapter 10 from module number 3, Backup and Archive. So let us go through some of the introduction part about the backup and archive. So backup, what is backup? Backup is an additional copy of production data created and retained for the sole purpose of recovering lost or corrupted data. So with growing business and regulatory demands for data storage, retention and availability, organizations are faced with the task of backing up an ever increasing amount of data. So this task becomes more challenging with the growth of information, stagnant IT budgets and less time for taking backups. So moreover, organizations need a quick restore of backed up data to meet business service level agreements, that is SLAs. So evaluating various backup methods along with the recovery consideration and retention requirements is an essential step to implement a successful backup and recovery solutions. So organizations generate and maintain large volumes of data, and most of the data is a fixed content. So this fixed content is rarely accessed after a period of time. But still, this data needs to be retained for several years to meet the regulatory compliance. So accumulation of such data in the primary storage increases the overall storage cost to the organization. So further, this increases the amount of data to be backed up, which in turn increases the time required to perform the backup. So for that reason, always the backup, whatever we are taking, it cannot be kept on the primary storage device. So this has to be kept on another storage device, so that we can avoid the increasing amount of data onto the primary device, which in turn leads to more data, more time taken for the creating the backup of that particular data. So this is about backup. So what is data archive? Data archiving is the process of moving data that is no longer actively used from primary storage to a low cost secondary storage device. So the data will be retained in the secondary storage for a long time to meet regulatory requirements. So moving the data from primary storage reduces the amount of data to be backed up. This reduces the time required to back up the data. In this video, we shall study some of the backup methods, architecture, topologies and backup targets. Also, backup optimization using data deduplication and backup in a virtualized environment. So let us study backup methods. Hot backup and cold backup are the two methods that are deployed for a backup. They are based on the state of the application when the backup is performed. So in case of a hot backup, the application will be up and running with the users accessing their data during the backup process. So this method of backup is also called as online backup. That means the application will be hosted, the application will be running. At that time only a backup will be created. So that backup is called as hot backup or a online backup. Next we have cold backup. It requires the application to be shut down during the backup process. Hence this method is referred to as an offline backup. So during cold backup, the application will be shut down. So the application will be closed at that time, the backup will be taken. So it is also called as offline backup. So the hot backup of online production data will be challenging because the data will be actively used and it will be keep on updated or changed by the user. For example, if a file is open, it is normally not backed up during the backup process. So in such cases, what will happen? An open file agent will be used to backup the open file. So these agents interact directly with the operating system or application and enable the creation of consistent copies of such open files. So in case of database environments, the use of the open file agents will not be enough because the agent should also support a consistent backup of all the database components. For example, consider a database will be composed of many files of varying sizes which occupies several file system. To ensure a consistent database backup, all the files need to be backed up in the same state. That means what? To have a consistent database backup, they are all should be in the same state. That does not necessarily mean that all the files needs to be backed up at the same time, but they all must be synchronized so that the database can be restored with a consistency. That means what? If there is any update that has happened on that particular database, all the files that are linked to that particular update query should be updated. So that when we are going to restore the database will have a consistency. So the disadvantage associated with the hot backup is that the agents usually affect the overall application performance. So this is the disadvantage that is associated with the hot backup. So consistent backups of databases also can be done by using a cold backup. So this requires the database to remain inactive during the backup. That means the database should not be updated or it should not be changed when we are taking the backup. So that means what? The application should be shut down when we are taking the backup. Of course, the disadvantage of a cold backup is that the database is inaccessible to users during the backup process. As I told, since the application will be shut down, the database or the data will be unavailable to the users during that time. So, a point in time PIT copy method is deployed in environments in which the impact of downtime from a cold backup or the performance impact resulting from hot backup is unacceptable. So the PIT or point in time copy is created from the production volume and is used as the source for the backup. Okay, so this reduces the impact on the production volume. So to ensure the consistency, it is not enough to backup only the production data for recovery. Certain attributes and properties attached to a file, such as permissions, owner of the file and other metadata, also need to be backed up. So these attributes are as important as the data itself and also must be backed up for the consistency. So in case of disaster recovery environment, bare metal recovery, that is BMR, refers to a backup in which all metadata, system information and application configurations are appropriately backed up for a full system recovery. So this BMR builds the base systems, which includes partitioning, the file system layout, the operating system, the application and all the relevant configurations. So BMR recovers the base system first before starting the recovery of the data files. Some BMR technologies, for example, server configuration backup, can recover a server even onto dissimilar hardware. The next topic we have is backup topologies. There are three basic topologies that are used in a backup environment. First is direct attached backup. Second one is LAN-based backup. And the third one is SAN-based backup. There is also a mixed topology that is used by combining LAN-based and SAN-based topologies. Let us study one by one. The first one we have is direct attached backup topology. So in this, the storage node is configured on a backup client and the backup device is attached directly to the client. So only the metadata is sent to the backup server through the LAN. So this configuration frees the LAN from backup traffic. Since only metadata is transferred, there is a less traffic. Okay, you can see in the figure the setup. The backup device is directly attached to dedicated to the backup client. As the environment grows, there will be a need for centralized management and sharing of backup devices to optimize the costs. So an appropriate solution is required to share the backup devices among multiple servers. So network-based topologies, that is LAN-based as well as SAN-based, provide the solutions to optimize the utilizations of backup devices. The figure shows there is a backup server and application server, or you can say storage node or a backup client, and we have the backup device, which is nothing but a storage device. So through LAN, backup server is connected to application server or backup client. Okay, so the metadata will be transferred to backup server and backup data will be sent to backup device. Next topology is LAN-based backup topology. In this, the client, the backup server, the storage node and the backup device are all connected to the LAN. You can see in the figure, we have application server or backup client, backup server, backup device and the storage node. All four of these are connected through LAN. So the data to be backed up is transferred from the backup client, that is source, to the backup device. Backup device will be the destination over the LAN, which might affect the network performance. Since all the data is transferred through LAN only, there might be a network performance. So this impact can be minimized by adopting a number of measures, such as configuring separate networks for backup and installing dedicated storage nodes for some application servers. Okay, since it might affect the network performance, it can be minimized by adopting some separate configured networks for backup only and some dedicated storage nodes for some of the application servers. You can see the backup data as well as metadata are both will be transferred through LAN only. Backup data will go to backup device and metadata will go to backup server. The third topology we have is SAN-based backup topology. It is also known as a LAN-free backup. The SAN-based backup topology is the most appropriate solution when a backup device needs to be shared among various clients. So in this case, the backup device and the clients are attached to the SAN as shown in the figure. You can see backup server and backup client are connected through LAN, and this backup client, backup device and the storage node, all three are connected to FCSAN. So there is no much load on the LAN, that is local area network, since only metadata will be transferred through LAN. Okay, and in turn the storage node is connected to LAN and which goes to the backup server. Okay, so the backup data will be transferred through FCSAN, so there is no much load on the LAN over here. So that is why it is called as LAN free backup. So in this example, you can say the client sends data to be backed up to the backup device over the SAN. Therefore, the backup data traffic is restricted only to the SAN and only the backup metadata is transported over the LAN. So the volume of metadata is significant when compared to the production data. The LAN performance is not degraded in this configuration. So the emergence of low-cost disks such as backup medium has enabled disk arrays to be attached to the SAN and used as the backup devices. A tape backup of these data backups on the disk can be created and shipped off-site for disaster recovery and long-term retention. At last, we shall see mixed topology, which uses both the LAN-based and the SAN-based topologies as shown in the figure. This topology might be implemented for several reasons, like which includes cost, server location, reduction in administrative overhead and performance consideration. Just see the figure. We have backup server, application server or backup client 1 and backup client 2 or application server 2. These three are connected through LAN. Okay, so and then we have storage node and backup device, which are connected through FCSAN to the backup client 1, and in turn it goes to backup client 2 also. Okay, so we have metadata flowing from client 1 as well as client 2 to the backup server, and we have backup data flowing from client 1 and client 2 to the backup device through the storage node. Okay, so this is how both the techniques can be combined for various reasons like cost, server location, reduction in administrative overhead, and performance considerations. This completes backup topologies. Thank you for watching.